Old Tom Kruse was an outback mailman. He brought the news on the back of his truck through sand and bog, summer and winter, like an old bulldog. Well, he never gave up.
Bird's bell. Dulcanina. That's all, Henry. Let's go.
Well, he's one of those blokes that he's become a legend in his lifetime.
Everybody in this part of the world loved him.
So raise a cheer for old Tom Kruse, a legend of the Outback Mail Brigade. Tough as nails, soft as butter, the kind of man of whom history's made. Yes, Tom Kruse is a hero of mine.
My very first trip to Birdwood, I can remember very clearly, because Harry Dean said, I'll give you £2. If you ever get to Birdsville, go and buy a drink for whoever is on the truck with you. And those days, beer was 5 shillings a bottle.
Well, Tom Kruse is a master of improvisation as mechanics are concerned. He'll get things going. If the situation's desperate, he'll get you home. And, well, they tell a story of how the fuel pump let him down, and he put a container of fuel up on the roof and knocked a hole through the bonnet and put a pipe to the carburetor, and you drive home.
From Lake Harry, Clayton, Dulcanina, to eat to dinner and the Mulca store, Mungerannie, Clifton Hills, Pandy Pandy and Goyder's Bore. He took the mail, that hero of mine.
We've been saying for the last 15, 20 years we're going to come back, especially that one over there, because there was the engine number, one of the very early ones in South Australia, on the Birdsville track. It was really the solution to a lot of problems.
Was that the best track? What could it do that others couldn't?
I wouldn't say it was the best track. It was the best track at the time. She used to give us lots of really good running, and a very reliable old thing.
What do you reckon we need to start it, Tom?
Well, I don't know if anyone's got the handle there, but I think I see the radio's got a bit of a knock on it.
Has it got any oil in it?
Oh, yes, you've got the dink of oil in it.
Give us a look.
Look here. Yeah, right there. And I reckon Shell oil was no good.
We didn't only have wheel tracks them days. And, you know, we got bogged a lot of times getting out here. Tom would have got bogged a lot of times. I rode up to him once after a 4-inch rain and he'd lost his shovel. And he's down his hands and knees raking the dirt away from his car, and he's singing I'm in heaven when I rode up behind him. And I said to him, Tom, if you're in heaven, I never want to get there.
All these stories about Tom being in heaven when he was bogged and broken down are actually true. I reckon he was, because he was one of the happiest men that I've ever met, I reckon.
In a sense, Tom was an ambassador for all that we in road transport stand for, whether you're driving a truck, loading a truck, making trucks, selling trucks, servicing them.
The story of Tom Kruse and his Leyland Badger began in 1936. The truck was bought new by pioneering Outback Mail contractor Harry Ding.
Harry Ding was having so much motor trouble on the Birdsville track, and it was the first diesel Harry Ding had, and what I will say, I'll tell you what, the thing never used to stop. Had a trailer attached, and most economical and reliable.
The early carriers were inventive. They needed to be. Harry Ding salvaged the rear axles and transmission of this wrecked Thornycroft and fitted them to the Leyland Badger in 1939. This made it a better truck for outback conditions. Four-wheel drive vehicles for most were still a way off.
The great thing is having the Thornycroft back end in it, which I would say is, well, you probably said 2-inch axle. And how can a 38 horsepower motor, don't know how well it's geared, how low, how can it turn one of those off? I mean, look, as far as the weakest point of this truck is a clutch plate. But other than that, no worries. And usually, I might say, as always, used to carry a clutch plate, a spare one.
In the back of Beyond, you can see just how strong he was and how physical he was, and now he's 96, and he's still a presence. And so there's more, obviously he's aged, but aged with a lot of dignity. But he's just a great character.
And I'm weaker in the arms. I mean, I know I am. I got a job to lift a schooner of beer these days. Once I could lift a 44-gallon drum without any worries. Not complaining, but how a person can deteriorate.
He's a bloke that has conjured up all sorts of emotions in a lot of people over a long, long time, but I guess he can be one of those blokes that can look you in the eye and say, I've done my best.
There's a generation of Australians that remember not just the truck, but Tom Cruise and the movie.
Australia was opened up by men like Tom that were able to improvise when they had a breakdown. They were hundreds of kilometres from anywhere. They had to improvise. And Tom is certainly very good at improvising and keeping vehicles going. And he would have known where the next problem was going to be and would have, you know, carried shackles or universal joints or fan belts and things with him.
Tom comes along, we'll be singing this song. When the mailman comes, we'll be there.
Oh, he's wonderful. He could be the most tender person.
Oh, well, he's a wonderful man. I mean, to put it in a nutshell, when you meet Tom at first, you're impressed by his intelligence and his charm. They are things that you see immediately.
It's only appropriate, I think, that we should be here where the famous and wonderfully restored Lowland Badger rests, the doughty vehicle that made so many journeys up and down the Birdsville track, expertly piloted by Tom through dust, storms, sand and flood.
Well, I think history, I think iconic, I think one of the great things of Australia in terms of what he did, which was typical of those times, a man that got the mail through, that got the petrol through, that got the supplies through to our outback stations and remote communities, and did it come hell or high water, rain, storm, drought, flood, the lot, and a great man too, a wonderful personality.
There we go.
Wonderful. Well,
it's done.
There it is. That's a pretty good likeness.
Well, I think we use the term hero far too frequently when it doesn't really apply, but I think in this case it does. He saved lives, for example, in many of his activities and stories, but as we all know, to get the mail through, I know what this was like as a soldier, you know, and that when we're in Vietnam or Malaya, Borneo, that letter coming through from home was of such critical importance in getting a letter out. And I can imagine it would be just the same for a remote station, stockmen, boundary riders, mum on the property, isolated, and along comes the mail truck. And Tom was telling me that on one of the stations, you know, the kids would race to the gate, and the first person who would open the gate, Tom would have a bag of lollies for. And it was just so important to see the mailman coming in because it brought a news of the outside world.
Tom Cruise was not only a great driver, but he had to know the way. You know, often he had to divert, and he'd go 20 miles there to come back. And so they could navigate by the stars or just by their sheer bushcraft. And wonderful mechanics. If they'd make parts out of mulga wood, if a cotter pin broke, they'd make a mulga pin and that sort of thing. And just geniuses at keeping vehicles going.
This fuel line repair was made by melting down 303 bullet casings Tom found in the bush. He did what he needed to do to get the mail through.
V826 calling 9LS. V826 calling 9LS.
I have never heard Tom swear. I think his family have assured me that he does, but I have never heard Tom swear, and we've been in some tricky situations together, and when the going has been really tough, I think rather than swearing, I reckon Tom just sits back and thinks, now what are we going to do about this?
out on the track, Birdsville and back. Come a rain, come hail, come sunshine. The dust and the flies that gets in your eyes and in the grill of the old ale and badger.
Tom in himself is legendary to our organisation, but he was like a breed of contractors that provided an essential service to many people in rural and outback Australia.
I mean, you really have achieved something nationally here, because I can remember 40 years ago living in Broken Hill and seeing the movie and reading all about your exploits. And I think most Australians were inspired. And to think the truck has been restored and is now going to be here in this wonderful museum for everybody to see, because it is a very popular museum. It's the greatest in Australia. I think it's going to be just a national icon.
We may never see the likes of Tom Kruse again, or the type of truck he drove.
He's always smiling. He's always got a kind word for everybody and a bit of a laugh, and yet he does his job relentlessly because the mail must go through.
It's amazing what the man's done. It's really enlightened people to see that a man has had so much courage for so many years to run the Birdsville track in harsh conditions as compared to today.
I don't think anybody's ever seen him angry. He's just a gentle, wonderful man, warm-hearted, strong, reliant. If he said he was going to do something, fire, flood, famine, two broken legs, didn't stop him from doing it. He just did it.
Tom Kruse has left the room, but the Tom Kruse story will never, ever die. It's there's too many people that carry the stories. Everybody that's had anything to do with it, or even those that haven't had anything to do with it, know a story about Tom. And look, all the stories never been told. There are just still dozens of stories out there, untold stories of what Tom did. Sure, Tom's not here, but the story will never die.